Test match cricket returns to Old Trafford for the first time since 2010, offering England the chance to win the Ashes over the next 5 days. Already 2-0 up in this Investec series, another victory in the third test would settle it. Even a draw would be enough to retain the urn. England were unchanged from the side that won by 347 runs at Lord's 11 days ago, with Kevin Peterson proving his fitness after recovering from a calf injury. By contrast, Australia made three changes, bringing in David Warner and Nathan Lyon for the first time in the series, and recalling Mitchell Starc at the expense of Phil Hughes, Ashton Agar and the injured James Pattinson. It was the tourists who won the toss and opted to bat first for the first time in the series, and they made a solid start. Openers Shane Watson and Chris Rogers making steady progress in the humid conditions. Rogers brought up their 50 partnership with the first of consecutive boundaries off the bowling of Tim Bresnan in the 15th over, as he quickly began to step up the scoring. Indeed, Rogers punished the next over from Jimmy Anderson with three more boundaries, the last of them here bringing up his own half century. Just his second in Test cricket, and coming at better than a runner ball as he turned a steady start for Australia into a really promising one. But at the other end, Watson hadn't been scoring so fluently, and he then provided England with their big breakthrough, edging Tim Bresnan to captain Alistair Cook and out for 19. Then just before lunch, a big call from the officials as England struck again with Usman Khawaja given out, caught behind off Graham Swan for just one. The batsman left shaking his head as his review controversially failed, and Australia were two down. That's the way it stayed at lunch, with Rogers unbeaten on 67, passing 20,000 first-class career runs in the process. Captain Michael Clarke now alongside him on 5. Australia ending the first session of the opening day on 92 for 2.